The non-farm payroll numbers that are expected to be released are forecast in the 216,000. The previous was 192. If you look at the ADP numbers that came out on Wednesday, was it Wednesday or Thursday anyways, the numbers did come in better than expected, a little bit higher than expected. You know, the market was looking for around 200, I believe, and market came in at about 220. Manufacturing PMI also came in much higher than expected. So normally when you look at that, you would expect that the numbers that are coming in here this morning on non-farm payroll would meet or maybe exceed them a little bit. But yet, when you look at the unemployment numbers that came out, they came in below, or actually they came in higher than expected. You know, you get a lot of conflicting numbers here. They're not consistent. And then you look at GDP quarter to quarter, and that also came worse than expected. It came in worse than expected. So, you know, those things normally don't say that, you know, that we couldn't get a much higher number in on-farm payroll. But anyways, if we do get a number that exceeds the 270 area, although I've put in there, I believe, 286, but any number that really pushes above 250, you know, 260, 270, definitely up in the 280 area. If we were to get numbers like that, you know, the dollar would definitely do very well, and specifically against the yen. And so what we would like to do is probably get in on the buy side, but we would have to do it when we look at this dollar yen over here matrix. You see you've got levels of resistance up here in the 70s, and then we've got this 79, which is the high of the month. So ideally what would probably happen is the market would break above this, probably push up into the 103 area, and then maybe at the 103 area, I mean, we'll find other walls up here. Once we get up there, we'll see them, they'll become visible. But, you know, we would probably want to use some of the walls that we break through them as potential areas of retracement to try to jump in and then see if we could ride the move. So again, that would be for better numbers, higher numbers coming in, let's say anything above 250, and if it's 280, if it's above 280, you know, we could probably see this dollar yen up at the 103.50 before it really slows down. Euro dollar, yeah, it would definitely a tumble. Although, again, I'd be a little bit weary of euro dollar. I mean, we definitely would want to get in on a buy side. Euro dollar has been really, really, really strong. Just not a lot of oppositions. If we were to see euro dollar at that point in time, if numbers came in that were really beneficial, you know, let's look for something down in the 138 level, big figure area, to try to get in on the buy side. We'll wait, like always. I'll be more inclined to try to get in on the long side on the dollar yen. I would definitely want the dollar yen. On the other hand, if numbers are bad, if we were to see numbers along the lines of 150 or below that, then this euro dollar will probably break the high of the month over here at the 139.04. Okay. $288. So we want to be long dollar yen. We want to be long dollar yen. And let's see. We can get some retracement back into the low 90s to 80s to get in on the long side. You can see euro dollar is hitting support, and support's doing its job, but we don't want to jump in here right now, not with these numbers. Wait for big figure if you're going to do something long on euro dollar. And waiting for dollar yen to see if we can get something back here in these low 90s. It seems like it wants to run. You can see big figure, it's doing its job. So hopefully we can get a little bit of retracement from big figure down to the 90 to 80 level. And then maybe there we could go ahead and get in on the long. But let's be patient. You can see euro dollar, that 24.20 is doing its job there, the wall on a 5 minute, 4 hour. Uh, And let's go ahead and protect that. Opportunities if they do present themselves, but not too late in the session. I mean, the other thing that can happen as I see this, let's evaluate what the market may really do here. If we can't get euro dollar, this is the level I'd like to see euro dollar at. If we can get it in this area, that's where we can explore taking long positions again. Being short. The issue of being short is it's not going to, doesn't seem like it wants to give you an easy, you know, runaway breakout trade. And so it may kind of act like it wants to go. It seems like maybe it's accumulating in here. Traders might be getting signals to go short, and then you get a market that completely turns back and finishes somewhere up here as it goes stop hunting for those that might be short right now in this area. And so they'll start looking for stops up here. The yens are doing the same thing. If you look at euro yen, you know, look at this. It's come back, broken the previous support, utilizing this previous resistance, or I'm sorry, this was resistance. We broke out of it, came back, didn't even hold. And now we're coming back to this other resistance that kind of did its job on the way up, did its job on the way down. And if that doesn't hold, then Euro-Yen will probably get down here into this area. So we'll see Euro-Yen get down here, and then maybe there it kind of fizzles and hangs around in here. That's kind of what's happening with Euro-Yen. Yeah, pound-dollar. I still think pound-dollar, I mean, although it's covered part of its spike, I wouldn't be surprised if pound-dollar did eventually work its way here, and then eventually get back here and maybe all the way back to this level up here. Yeah, initially you're looking at pound dollar retracement into this area, and then all this here, right in here. This is your next target for pound dollar.